The British and Irish Lions will make or break their tour here in the capital city tonight. After being badly mauled in Christchurch last Saturday, the tourists have spent most of the week since stewing over the Brian O'Driscoll incident. But tonight that has to be forgotten in the quest to even up the three test series. The Westpac Stadium in Wellington hosts its first Lions test tonight, and it's nice to report conditions couldn't be better. It's been a beautifully fine day, and that's translated into a perfect night for rugby. A bit breezy and cool, but underfoot conditions absolutely ideal. And again tonight, as in Christchurch last week, a huge contingent of Lions supporters are here, and they surely deserve a better performance than their team gave them last weekend. What a magnificent atmosphere we have here in the capital city as we pop into the dressing room. Last minute preparations going on in there. The All Blacks were very much on the front foot in the test match last week, but it all starts again here tonight. Ali Williams, who had a big one in Christchurch, a relaxed looking Daniel Carter, and Mills Muliaina back in the starting lineup tonight. Chance to welcome our international audience, and there will be a huge audience tonight watching these pictures as of Clive Woodward, a man under some real pressure, heads up into the coaching box. So if you're watching the game in South Africa, Australia, Asia, North America, the Pacific Islands, or here in New Zealand, welcome to the Westpac Stadium. And here come the Lions, and they do have massive support here tonight, no doubt about that. So here they come for the second test. So many changes in the Lions forward pack from last week. A complete clean out of the loose trio, a new look, a lock in Donica O'Callaghan, but arguably the most important change at hooker, where Steve Thompson replaces Shane Byrne. Thompson will need to find his jumpers in the line-out, an area that killed the Lions last week. And only one player in this back line, halfback Dwayne Peel, is wearing the same number as last week in Christchurch. The most obvious change is a first five where Johnny Wilkinson goes back, but the man who has to lead them is Gareth Thomas. The Welshman is a proven leader, and his combination with Gavin Henson will be fascinating to watch. That's the reserve bench, all seven of them, for the Lions tonight. And now the crowd waits in anticipation for the All Blacks. Paddy O'Brien has a peek in there, about to head off to Dublin to run the referees on the IRB, Paddy O'Brien. And now here comes Tana Umanga. The All Blacks all kitted up, ready to go. The Lions in their tracksuits. And let's just stand by for this welcome. Forced change in the All Black pack this week, with Greg Somerville in for Carl Heyman, who has a poisoned toe. One of the real standouts in the All Black eight last week was Ali Williams. There had been question marks in the past about Williams at this level, but his performance in Christchurch went a long way towards changing those perceptions. And three changes in the All Black back line. One of these sees Byron Callagher get the nod over his arch rival Justin Marshall. Callagher was a major success on the European Tour last year, and his form was solid during Super 12. The other two changes, Mills Muliaina for Leon McDonald at fullback, Rico Gear on the right wing in place of Doug Howlett, and the sub bench for the All Blacks.
Of New Zealand. To sing the Lions song, Mark Burrows.
Together we
gentlemen, please remain standing for the National Anthem of New Zealand to be sung by Hayley Westenrow.
Scene has been set here at the Westpac Stadium. Murray Mexted, former All Black, with me as the All Blacks move to do the haka. Murray, this is just incredible.
Well, I think it's something special, actually. I've been to a few of these, Nisbo, as you're aware, but there's something quite special about this. So much feeling and heart. In fact, when I look around the stand, there is more red than black. So it's an equal support base here. The one side, the red side, I guess, our expectation of what could be.
Accepting the challenge in a somewhat different manner to what we saw at Jade Stadium last week. But what a din in the stadium. Let's quickly go sideline to Ian Smith, our man on the sideline, just as the haka finishes again. And Smithy, tell us about conditions.
Well, conditions are absolutely perfect underfoot. Just what the All Black coach Graham Henry pleaded for after last week's win. Give us a dry track. Well, they've both got a perfectly dry track. The wind is as swirl in Nisbo as it does in this bowl-shaped stadium. At the moment, you tend to think it favours the All Blacks and Tanarumanga just coming across to the sideline to get a bit of grip for the hands, I think. It's been a trying week for him. And the reception here for both these sides and the haka, the anthems, I must say, the first encounters, the first 5 to 10 minutes, should be unbelievably confrontational.
Here's tonight's referee, Andrew Cole from Australia, with Jonathan Kaplan of South Africa and Stuart Dickinson of Australia running the sides. And Mark Lawrence of South Africa is the television match official. Well, there's been so much written, so much spoken about the second test match. And we're about to get started. The Lions having a last little huddle. And it won't be long. It looks as though the Lions are going to kick off. So the All Blacks get the first reception, and very important for them to get it right.
Yes, always is the opening few minutes of this game. Quite a psychological period, actually. But interesting to see the Lions accept the challenge. As you say, Nisbo, very different from last week. And the crowd, of course, they played their part too. The chant of Lions, Lions, Lions was just phenomenal during the half.
Andrew Cole blows the whistle. Time on in the second test as the ball holds up and it bounces off the shoulder and it's into the arms of Umanga. Oh boy, let's see whether that was propelled forward by the hand. Certainly the impression was it came off the shoulder of Richie McCaw.
It was off the shoulder too. I think that was absolutely legitimate, but you'd have to forgive the referee for missing it, I guess.
A bit of a break for the Lions in the first 30 seconds of the game. Now let's have a look at the first set piece.
Well, the weights have changed from last week. The Lions actually have an advantage of 30 kgs. That's quite a lot.
Dwayne Peel to feed this first scrum.
Shoulder! Shoulder on!
Held in the back by Ryan Jones. Now Peel away for Wilkinson. Heaves it wide to Thomas. Bit of a gap opens up for Thomas. Gets support there from Shane Williams. And he in turn hands it off to O'Connell, the big lock forward. Now Peel for Wilkinson. Charge in the middle of the park from O'Callaghan. And the Lions making a strong start. Slowly. Now Thomas again. He's already had one good run. He's got another one. He's got to score under the posts. Gareth Thomas, the captain.
Wow, what an incredible start, Lions. Twice he featured, Gareth Thomas. The first time with the ball made a necessary yardage. But the second time he took the inside track and there was nobody home. Look at this. Inside Maolamu and nobody inside. So that wasn't Muliaina's problem. He came back to save. Brilliant line.
Over goes the conversion. Gareth Thomas, who only on Sunday was handed the captaincy of this touring party. He started with one big run, and here he goes again. And the All Black defence was non-existent. And Gareth Thomas of Wales gets the try.
Where were the loosies? That's what they'll say. Where were the loose forwards? Richie McCaw was the closest, about to 10, 15 metres away and retreating. There was no defence there at all. And the new Lions captain, what a dream start.
So the All Blacks kick off. What a start it has been to the game as Ryan Jones takes it down. And what a tour he's had, considering he came in as a replacement.
Ball is out.
Ball is out. And oh, here's a gap up the middle. Now, Peel. He's got to find some support. He's lost his support, but Moody's controlled it brilliantly.
Leave it five.
Huge gaps in the All Blacks' defence as Jenkins charges in. All Blacks just not in the game as yet. 3 minutes gone. Peel, Wilkinson. Here's Thomas, who got the try. They finally nail him. First time he's been tackled. He's held the ball three times. All Blacks driving hard. Now Peel goes again. Finds another little gap. In close. Lions driving over the ball. Looks like the All Blacks might have turned them now. Played the ball on the ground.
Well, originally when he touched it, he came from behind, which was legit. And then he continued to play it off his feet.
Murray, where's the defence around the fringes? That's what they've got to be saying in that camp. Busted by Thomas, busted by Peel twice. No defence in close.
That's right. That's obviously where they're targeting. So McCaw coming from behind, okay. But of course you can't continue. Yes, no defence there, Smithy. Absolutely correct. Almost broke down here, but it was beautifully recovered by Moody.
Chance here to make it 10 points to nil inside the first 5 minutes of the game. just faded away at the last minute.
Lions have got it though, I think.
Whoa, whoa. Stay out, stay out, stay out. Stay out. Back you go, back you go. Back you go. Back you go.
Well, just getting a little overexcited,
five,
a little
five.
Over-exuberant.
That's silly. You were winning the ball yeah. and you went right over. Just silly. Stay out of it.
And I think the referee summed that up.
Yeah. Well, the kick at goal just faded at the last second and it wasn't claimed by the All Blacks and the Lions had it.
Well, he's got a penchant, hasn't he, for doing boneheaded things under the post. Last week it cost him time in the bin, Paul O'Connell. But this was clearly Lions' ball. Clean ball, too.
Well, he didn't even have it in his arms, you know. He was just a shoulder charge as well. So, New Zealand ball first time.
Kevin Mealamu can't hear the call. Beautifully taken down by Jack Williams, feeding it off to Collins.
Roll away,
and the All Blacks get a feel of the ball, really, for the first time. And back it goes to Carter. Lucy. That's a lovely kick from Carter. And Lucy doesn't have too many options available to him here.
Out of the 10, come back.
Hoisting it away. Muliaina coming for, beautifully taken by Mills Muliaina. And the All Blacks in control on the Lions 10-metre line. Delayed pass. Kick made by Major. Now this could bounce anywhere. And it's... he let it go. No, it was a penalty. Playing an advantage, Andrew Cole. As the ball was in danger of heading over the dead ball line. And a penalty for offside.
Fantastic kick, Dan Carter, putting the heat on Lucy, who returned it. And did you see the Muliaina gather? I mean, he lurched forward and caught it on his knees. Have a look at this. This is absolutely wonderful. Down on one knee, right leg it out, looking for a gap. His footwork, his balance, his poise. Well, a 7-point lead. The All Blacks would dearly love to cut that back a bit.
Dan Carter's first kick of the night is on target. 7-3.
Now that was interesting, wasn't it? When Carter kicked the goal, you couldn't hear anywhere near the noise you heard when the Lions scored. I think the local crowd has been outgunned at the stage, Nisbo.
Well, we thought there was a large number of red jerseys in Christchurch. Boy. Huge here. Wilkinson goes straight up the middle. Claimed by McCaw.
Leave it red, onside. Roll away,
Williams four. Takes a couple of metres. Coming now for Kelleher. Spins it wide. Carter wants to have a bit of a dab away to Major. Hesitation. Now Williams waiting for him to hit the deck and knocked on by one of the Lions. Well, it looked like it.
Leave it blue.
Ball dropped down. Now Peel and thumping defence on O'Connell. The two Irishmen in the middle row now. Here's Wilkinson away for Jones. Well contained though by Kelleher. Now Peel. Kelleher puts him away. All Blacks starting to get into the game now.
Hold on. Back you go, number two.
Well, there's a bit of niggle there, all right. Well, Steve Thompson, Well, the key to that one was black over the ball. All black numbers over the ball.
The key to that also, Murray, is Byron Callaghan knowing that his opposition has had the best of the first 10 minutes and making a statement. A very timely one.
Yes. He's explosive when he makes a decision, Byron Callaghan. And on defence, he did that then. He wrapped him up, ball and all. I actually thought Peel placed the ball beautifully, but this is where the numbers. And, of course, Richie McCaw was on his feet and entitled to go for that there. And that's... Is that Woodman just climbing all over?
Kevin Mialamu to throw. 10 minutes gone. An explosive start to the second test. Mialamu heading towards the back of the lineout. The Lions are 1-1 against the throw.
Let it go through. You're off your feet.
Yeah, they did win that one against the throw. And if you'll see, if you'd noticed... There was hands holding hands. In other words, they weren't able to jump. So something will have to happen to stop that. Have a look.
Steve Thompson, how often do you see a hooker winning it at the back?
Well, Chris Jack was pushed out of the line.
Pretty lax refereeing on that occasion. As the Lions spin away.
Let it go!
New Zealand ball, that's a little psychological victory. That scrum turned, it was picked up by Ryan Jones, he was driven back in. New Zealand forwards getting the forward motion.
It's straight. Crouch and hold. Engage.
Scrum, slight angle. Well, very interesting situation.
Get
the
up,
scrum.
Guys,
the Lions haven't changed.
Get your bind.
Totally
get your
bind. Their back row. Two open side flanker style of players. East to beat.
Engage.
Moody.
Off the scrum.
Now Callaghan feeds it off to Carter. Looking to dab it in behind Robinson. Here come the runners. And it's just stayed in the field of play. Robinson's done brilliantly.
Leave it.
He got out of jail, Robinson.
He sure did. Oh, Peel's lost it. He's knocked it on, so they're playing an advantage here. Well, Robinson won't look too kindly upon his halfback after all the hard work that he did.
Yes, he just bought a little bit of time. He didn't make much yardage. So the kick was on the spot, really. Look at the two All Black chasers. It bounced nicely for Robinson. Slipped the tackle, slipped the second. He actually got out of it well, didn't he? Wrapped up by McCaw and Carter.
Here's a great opportunity. Best attacking opportunity for the All Blacks so far in the match. So Iolo hands it off to Callaghan. Now Carter looking for the runners. Now it's out with Muliaina. Chance on the right wing for Rico Gear, but they ran out of room. And the Lions flying across in defence.
Well, it was good defence too. It drifted across field. They were unable to pull it in. It was good ball. Just giving it to Muliaina with a bit of space.
You've got to give the Lions a lot of credit here for the sliding defence. Not just one, but four there. Very organised indeed.
So New Zealand having employed that sort of tactic quite often from set play where they run a front line and a second line where they attack from. I guess the next time you see them do that, they'll bring a player back towards the action to try and stop that drifting defence.
Biggest moment of the game for Steve Thompson here.
I think the Prince is nervous.
Here's Thompson. Oh, he's gone way to the back. It was a clean line-out win, so they should be able to get the ball into touch at least from here. Peel will be looking for Wilkinson as they charge at him, and he drills it nicely. Rico Gear will throw it quickly.
He will indeed.
Off it goes to Muliaina. But they come up in a pretty good line, had the Lions. Now Callaghan drags it out for Collins. On it goes to Sivivatu. Collins goes again. Blindside work. Mialamu. Can't afford to go high on Kevin Mialamu. Now it's with Richie McCaw. Got himself into the gap. Got it away to Williams.
Let it go!
There it is again for Kelleher. They're all over him. Collins charging.
Still go forward.
Seven, let it go.
All Blacks really now starting to find their feet. Sivivatu very nearly slipped through.
And he offloaded
two.
Got the pass away. He's playing an advantage.
Number two.
And it's against Steve Thompson.
No, come through
and
the game.
And they want to argue.
One
of the features of the Lions tour. They always want to argue.
Through the gate at the back. It's been, in fact, it's been a hallmark of the tour for the Lions coming in from the side. And then, of course, the complaint afterwards when they're penalised. But that was seven dynamic phases from New Zealand, breaking the advantage line every time, offloading in the tackle. It's a good go-forward position, which they'd be wanting to get by this stage in the game.
Just a little concern for Richie McCaw as Daniel Carter lines this one up. But Greg Somerville in for Heyman this week. Good in pursuit, and that's where the infringement was made by Steve Thompson.
Well, he came in from... You've got to come in from in through the gate, they say, right, from the back. Well, he came in from the back of the New Zealand ruck. So he had no right to challenge. So McCaw with some blood, Smithy.
Yeah, it's a blood bin at this point, but they're not taking him off. It's a timely shot at goal. Hopefully they'll get him right. So when Richie McCaw, any attention to him, everyone in these here parts get very nervous.
Is just one after the early Thomas try, 7-6.
Well, the reason, Smithy, you were referring to everyone being concerned about McCaw is because there's no specialist open side in the reserves. Is that your reference?
Absolutely. So there was activity from Gibbs and Luaki, of course.
Well, I dare say that Rodney Suialo would move into that open side position.
Wilkinson restarts. Waiting for it, McCaw. Boy, that was a marginal one.
Beautifully taken, and in fact the whole thing was good, wasn't it?
Back it goes for the kick to be made. It's off the side of the boot somewhat. I don't know whether he'd quite landed when he got hit. We'll have to wait and see, but the timing, if he did get it right, was exquisite.
And beautifully taken, though, by McCaw under pressure. Absolutely wonderful. And still positioning the ball so the All Blacks could get out of the out of jail.
Look at all the talking going on. Can you believe it? All intended to influence the referee. Now the Lions line out working a lot better. Lost by the Lions. Here's a chance with Carter running hard. Carter still going. Carter with his pace. Gets a point. Skipper, after all that's happened to him this week, is in to score the first try.
Well, blistering, some may say breathtaking, but outstanding from the turnover. It was perpetual motion. Dan Carter, have a little look at this. The tackle was major. Umanga seized the opportunity, gave it to Carter, and he went, and he went, and he went. And he went here and off to load it perfectly to the man that gave him the ball.
Pathetic tackling from the Lions. They've been quite good in defence up to this point. But Gavin Henson won't want to look at the first effort he made. Neither Gareth Thomas either. It was Gareth Thomas knocking it on to start with. And I can tell you, Murray, there's a bit of finger pointing going in the crowd now because Umanga got heaps and all of a sudden he's had his say. And the Blacks are outnumbering the Reds all of a sudden noise-wise.
Well, a few of them turning around and facing the boys in red, two in the grandstand.
Absolutely, there's plenty of it. Plenty of it.
You know, the clenched fist and the big smile. Black is back.
So the All Blacks absorbed that early pressure, conceded the early try. As Carter's kick is through. And Tana Umanga has come up with his 34th test try. And here is the finish of it. And that would be a sweet moment after all the pressure that has been heaped on this bloke this week. And just a little smile there. Wilkinson kicks off again. This one not going quite as far. McCaw takes it down beautifully.
Oh, what a warrior. What a trooper, McCaw.
Major turns and kicks it off down to Robinson. He's an elusive runner. He can be dangerous, but he decides to kick, and that's a horrible kick. They're howling for a late tackle, I think, the Lions. It's not been given. And an awful kick. Well, it's just gone a little pear-shaped here for the Lions after their wonderful start.
I didn't see anything.
Well, they had an opportunity then to counter-attack, I thought, Robinson, but he failed to do so. He just kicked it down the centre of the field. Which, it was a shocking kick too, wasn't it? And Mulu'aina, he wanted to have a go, but he saw there was space to the left, and he thought, we could take 30 metres, and they did.
Chris Jack off the top. Now Carter, happy to have a run at them. Kelleher gets it quickly. Here's Umanga in close.
Well, off
just
two.
Out from the 22. Carter, quick recycling of the ball. Williams flicks it back and field to Somerville. Now here's Kelleher again. Jack.
Come back around.
10 out from
two.
The 22.
Leave it red.
Thompson almost went on the wrong side again. Here's Soialo.
Well, it's
four.
A barrage of attack from the
Jerry Collins, it's fast and furious at the moment. Now here's Rico Gear out wide. The bounce will be interesting. And it beats everybody. Well, that's a Lions tactic. With Rico Gear camped out way out on the right wing side.
So a solid stanza here of committed attack from Black, just breaking the line.
Thompson's throwing's been okay so far. Again, they go deep. Ryan Jones has it. It's guaranteed ball. You can't mark up on that. Wilkinson forced onto his right boot and he hooks it out, but it's offside. Richie McCaw offside. The battle scars showing on Richie McCaw.
No, sorry, it was four.
Well, it's been fast and furious this opening quarter. We've had a quarter of the game. And, of course, the Lions started with an incredible territorial advantage in the first 10 minutes. And now it's swung back New Zealand's way. Possession now 55% New Zealand.
Step over.
Favour the Lions, just the edge here, much improved from last week.
Thompson, players running all over the place. Oh, that was a tough one. Taken quickly and away goes Peel. Didn't take it from the right mark. Players haven't heard the whistle here.
Lewis Moody's got to go here, or something's got to happen to him. He started this.
Let's go. Get back. Just get
He's
back.
He's on the floor too. What's up?
Get back.
He ran from a long way,
back.
Lewis Moody, to get involved.
Well, obviously, that's the message, isn't it, that the Lions have got.
Go. Take them back.
Be the aggressor.
Take them back.
I mean, we've been talking about it for the last few days.
Let's have a listen and see what the touch judges have to say here. Initially, the players didn't hear the whistle.
Number 9 carried on playing after he blew the whistle. Yeah. And number 7, Black, went on with a tackle, and then everyone jumped in. So it's...
Yeah, something similar.
Seven didn't hear the whistle, 9 didn't hear it. Nice, calm down, everyone relax and take a bit of time, mate. We're off.
Yeah, I think Stuart Dickinson's got it right here.
Well, there's magnificent competition in there by Ali Williams.
There was always going to be a penalty to the Lions anyway, and so that stands.
So the Lions with one line out against the throw, New Zealand none, although the last one was very close. Ali Williams getting a hand to it.
Thompson. Tipped on the Lions side.
Lost.
Yeah, lost it forward. Did Paul O'Connell. Well, it was certainly one on the Lions side, but O'Connell knocked it forward.
So that was Easterby who was jumping.
Plenty of line-out options tonight with Easterby and Jones.
Tight head.
Ball's gone through the All Black scrum and out the back of the Lions scrum. Now Wilkinson has it. Fires it out into midfield to Thomas. Thomas looking to have a go.
Ruck! Ruck! Onside.
It's there for Peel. Now Jones slips the pass. Peel again. Williams. Jenkins to Thompson. Did well to bring it back into the field of play.
Plenty of lines out to the right. Look at that.
That's going to be a penalty against Aaron Major. He thought the ball was out. He was wrong. Wilkinson's going to have a drop kick. It'll be a penalty anyway. And it was worth the try.
You can't come through. Bind on. Offside, number 12.
So the pressure comes on to New Zealand inside the 22. Possession exactly equal now, 50-50.
Just be a bit careful here. This is unless he indicates he's going to kick for goal, which I think he's done now, but this is about the spot they scored against Wellington.
So the ball must have been kicked through, I think. Well, he claimed he came in from behind, which he did, but of course he wasn't bound.
So here's Johnny Wilkinson from a pretty acute angle. Beautiful. 13 points to 10.
An excellent kick.
The Lions are here 2 hours before the game. We'll know why he knocks them over. He practices from that angle. And plenty of them, even more acute.
Carter's kick is down the centre. Oh, they've lost it, the Lions.
Leave it, Fred!
A bad mistake. And that was always going to be a penalty.
Get away from it.
Trying to slow the ball down to let the troops get back. And it's going to cost them 3 points, most likely.
We'll put it down to Paul O'Connell. Nisbo, remember, it was he, when the Lions were hot on attack, who gave away the silly penalty under the bin. He hasn't really been able to wrap his hands around the ball successfully since.
Yeah, it was a late call, actually. Moody, I think, called originally. But the referee was screaming out, let it go, let it go. And in the end, Byron Kelleher appealed for the penalty and got it.
So less than a minute after Wilkinson landed a penalty, here's Carter to restore the 6-point margin. So 16 points to 10, and we've still got about 12 minutes remaining in the first half. This one goes a bit further. McCaw lining it up. Goes for a bit of a gallop, Richie McCaw. And the Lions have won it. Wilkinson's going to have a drop kick. And he's put it away. Well, it wasn't that difficult. He had time on his hands. But they'll take the points any way they can get them.
Oh, of course. Accumulation of points is the style of the British Lions, no doubt about that.
Downfield goes Major. Jones misjudging. Off it goes to Lucy. He's had a fairly quiet game so far. Sevi Vaatu went in and Lucy won it.
Leave it five.
So the Lions have the momentum just on the All Black side of halfway.
Get out of it.
Well, I thought rucking had been outlawed, but obviously not.
Get back. Back you go.
Oh, it's Steve Thompson. He's been in the middle of everything, hasn't he?
Five, same thing. Roll off it. Yeah, you're up here. Goal, please.
This was miraculously recovered. Have a look at this. Sidi Vaatu jumped, and so did Byron Kelleher, which is bad communication. Lucy came away with it.
There is a suspicion at ground level that the wind's picked up a bit and it's turned a wee bit to favour the Lions. This won't be a problem distance-wise thus.
Dead on front.
Looking to land his second penalty goal. Looks good.
Well, the deep sigh. And Steve Hansen in the middle. Ah, there is a real man underneath there.
And a thirsty one.
Really is living up to its billing this game. The try early by Thomas. Really set it up. And it hasn't stopped. 30 minutes gone. Grabbed by McCaw. The All Blacks have it. Collins off to Somerville. Wrestling his way downfield, held up by Thompson though.
Red.
Blind side they go with Kevin Mialamu. Scraps his way down a metre or so. Now Kelleher off to McCaw. Big defence on Richie McCaw.
Gary Collins wanting to go through the centre.
Here's Kelleher looking to open it up. Kelleher still going. Kelleher almost there.
Ooh, reminiscent of France. I think he should have let it go. Gear on the outside.
They've got a 5 metre scrum, the All Blacks.
First. No, no, not now. Get up first.
And look at Gareth Thomas. They really do get excited. And they do put enormous pressure on these referees.
Kelleher, magnificent little break. Split the line. Left them groping. We can't see, but just to his right, Rico Gear is unmarked.
I think in all fairness, he was shut down there, Byron Kelleher. The pass had to go a lot earlier. What the Lions are arguing here, that he didn't let go of the ball. Lucy got up and was absolutely livid, as with Gareth Thomas.
I didn't notice Thomas getting up either, Smithy, to be fair. Lying all over it.
This will be an interesting scrum. Have a look at this. Somerville on the near side. This is Jenkins.
Stand up, no ball, no ball, stand up. Stand up, no ball. No ball.
The heat is on.
Crouch and hold.
Big scrum.
Well, good solid scrum, New Zealand. Very good.
Pass. Number nine.
Edging them back a metre or two. Now cleared away for Carter. Off to Umanga, back to Carter. Good defence by the Lions. Now they get it wide to Sivi Vaatu. He's in. Second for the All Blacks.
know about attack. Give them space. They're mercurial. Twice I thought the ball had been stopped dead in its tracks by the Lions' defence, but it kept moving. Have a look at this one here. Somehow they got that ball free, and it was Gear gave the last pass. No one was going to stop Sidibata at that stage.
Oh, terrific play, Aaron Major, to be able to free the ball. That was the key. Lovely wraparound move. Carter involved twice. At that point, Jason Robertson thought he had it cut off at the pass. Gear lapped around. Just a little basketball pass, really, wasn't it? And this bloke is unstoppable from here. He sees that white line. He says, "You're mine." And they can't stop him. He almost rips the ball clear. He's just too strong.
He almost lost the ball, I thought.
He's number five. Touchdown report after the scrum broke up. Just watch the hand coming through, okay?
He's the wrong man there.
Okay, all right. Yeah. But let's go with the ball, play the whistle.
That's an interesting call. He said it's the wrong man. So he must have known the bloke that did it then.
Oh, I thought he was quite cunning, actually. He said, oh, instead of saying, ref, it wasn't me, he said the right thing. He challenged the referee.
Listen to this guy on screen, worth his weight in gold. He is a magnificent footballer, as is this bloke, but you've got to hand it to Daniel Carter for the ability to seize an opportunity. He really has been instrumental in both tries.
I think that one was such a marvellous team try, though, Smithy. They were all interreacting, weren't they, under pressure, and the whole objective, create space, and that's what they did for Sidibata.
Tough kick here. Just away, so an unconverted try for Sidibata, his sixth try in just his third international. Lovely interchange of passes, freed up by Major, and Sidibata, not many are going to stop him from there.
Nisbo, there were four great passes under, you know, real pressure there. Tacklers on all over the top of them.
Again, McCaw wants it. Ooh, he's got it now. And Major gets the kickoff downfield. And it's a good one too from Aaron Major, who's made a strong contribution again tonight.
Well, the combination midfield's working, that's for sure.
Step over.
Thompson to throw, goes short.
5 metres.
Not 5 metres. McCaw wants to take it quickly, does so. Collins will thump it up. 10-metre line in Lions territory. Taken out by Kelleher for Tony Woodcock. Now a change of direction. Carter looks on the inside.
Oh, well covered. Well covered Lions.
They're a pretty well drilled defensive screen. Major stabs it through. Lucy waiting for a favourable bounce, and he couldn't do much else.
Well, it was very effective. The All Blacks, they tried to the right, no luck. They now went left. Major spotted the gap, kicked the ball on the top, you'll notice. That's why it's rolling end on end. It set up for Lucy, but he had no option because the pressure was there. Brought by the Lions.
Hacked away by the Lions, so Sidibata has to come and tidy up.
Onside, Red!
Well, he was tempted, Sidibata, to throw the big Fijian pass.
Onside.
Which, of course, could be intercepted.
All Blacks losing 30 metres in that move, but they're going to attack again. Here's Muliaina having a go, but he's well and truly taken.
Let it go, Sidibata!
Good work by McCaw. Gallagher again. Oh, they've got numbers here, and they're mainly against forwards, too. Collins, Soialo, stabbing it through. Lucy this time gets a nice bounce.
I don't think that's out.
No, it's not. Taken by Carter, away for Major. Fires it wide for Jack. He in turn gave it back to Carter.
Leave it one, roll away.
So the All Blacks still have it.
Number eight.
Heap of movement in the game.
Nobody home there.
Kelleher having a whale of a time.
Well, seeing clearly the picture, I think, that time.
Well, the Lions were superb in defence there. The All Blacks had plenty of opportunity to move the ball wide. They were snuffed at every opportunity until Kelleher thought enough is enough. Let's at least get some field position out of that.
Aaron Major in a bit of trouble out of midfield. He's gone back into position, but I think he wants to get the replacement player on.
And that is Nonu.
Lions line out a huge improvement tonight.
Leave it one, leave it.
Mind you, it had to be. Coming for Dwayne Peel. And that's a good kick by the Welshman. Very good kick. Now let's just see how Aaron Major is. I don't know. I don't think he can continue. It looks like a hamstring, Smithy.
Yes, he's limping.
Yep. And there's no coming back from those. Not in a hurry anyway. So instantly, Nonu was on in 21. He's on at home.
Time out, injury.
And that'll slide Umunga into second, I would say. No, they're talking about it. I think Umunga's staying at centre.
Contact then. 21.
Well, I remember I used to call these two father and son.
Can we get a 10-2 here? Time out.
The father was looking after the son for those first couple of NPC seasons. And all of a sudden the son grew up to a fully grown order.
Sir Clive heading under the stand with 2 minutes to go. Steve Thompson being attended to, but he's okay. So Ma'anonu now into the midfield in place of Aaron Major.
Now, this is incredible. The All Blacks have put the wrong bloke on.
Oh, blimey.
Nonu's gone back off now, and on comes Leon McDonald. So Miliaina will go to centre, McDonald at the back. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Nonu took his position and has been dragged. And Lyndon Bray was the official that interjected just in time. Once he was involved, that was it.
Okay, so the message was McDonald, but Nonu thought, or just assumed that as the midfield back had gone off, he was on.
All Black line-out works well again. Now to Collins out in centre field. So'oyalo back to Carter. Good defence. Here's Leon McDonald getting an early touch. Kelleher again. Oh, pass has gone behind Umunga.
Great pass.
It's a beautiful pass. Now Gear off to Mialamu. Probably didn't realise it was Mialamu. Thought it might have been a fellow back. Now McCaw cleans it out. All Blacks playing at real pace. Greg Somerville straight up the middle. Ball bounces clear. It's untidy. Oh, great work by Kelleher. Just showing his strength. Here's Rico Gear.
Well done by Gear as well.
Thompson having a go. Now McCaw throwing himself all over the place tonight.
Onside.
Laid the ball back beautifully.
He does. Carter. Away for So'oyalo. Busting his way downfield.
Let it go, Red. Let it go.
Wilkinson went hard at him. Now Kelleher working blindside again. Taken down by his opposite.
Just sniping.
All Blacks, a few of them lurking way out here on the right wing side as Somerville gets hit hard. Now Collins. Big defence here by the Lions.
Huge defence. 9 phases.
They cannot afford really to concede anything before half time. Here they come again. Umunga. The Lions there in numbers.
Turnover. Well, tremendous defence. Lions take a bow. They had to. They were throwing everything at them, New Zealand.
It's number three. Let's go back. Back you go. Mark, can you give me a time? Has the hooter gone? Has the hooter gone?
He wasn't sure, Andrew Cole, where the hooter had gone. It has now. And Wilkinson will kick this out. And that'll take us to half time. And everybody can have a bit of a breather. It's been all on here in the first 40 minutes. The All Blacks had to absorb a fair bit of early pressure. but they've come out of it 2-1 and lead 21-13.
Well, a real test match we've got on our hands here, that's for sure. Magnificent first half, wasn't it? Gareth Thomas, the new captain, bursting out of the blocks and nailing a try. Ascendancy to the Lions. The All Blacks came back, and did they ever. They came back, they threw, they smashed, they ran, they scored. And they scored a couple of fantastic tries and just ground their way to a victory, I guess, in the first half, just 21-13.
A much better Lions team in this second test, but they still are behind at halftime. The All Blacks leading 21-13. So the players back on the field, just waiting for the choir to leave.
Yes, I mean, very generous, I think, of New Zealanders to allow a Welsh choir onto the field and have the whole crowd singing Bread of Heaven. I mean, where are we?
Yes. You just imagine that at the Millennium Stadium in New Zealand.
There's no way ever.
Here we go. Second half is underway on this second test match. And the Lions have not been able to control the kickoff. They've knocked it on. And they get a play advantage here as the All Blacks will attack early. Short pass goes to Umanga. And he's well taken. There has been some thunderous defence in this game. Here's Collins working it to Carter. Got it back to Jerry Collins. And the All Blacks have it. Five out from the 22. And there's a Lions player down too as Richie McCaw steps.
Steps
in. Johnny Wilkins is in real trouble. All Blacks have lost the ball. And hello, there's a penalty. Now offside. Let's keep an eye on Wilkinson here.
Number three offside.
They've lost down two key players offside on this tour already. And it's not surprising the medics have come at 100 miles an hour.
When Umanga cut back and he got the short pass from Carter, I've got a feeling that Wilkinson may have been one of the tacklers there. He's made a couple of very aggressive bulk tackles in the first half, and he's left the arm outstretched. This occasion, he may have caught it.
Very interesting to see New Zealand moving the ball with a little bit of room to move. They actually looked to me like they created space, and the space was closed down by Lions players offside. I mean, there's a classic example there, really.
Well, Julian White there making no effort. Now let's keep an eye on Wilkinson.
Looks like right shoulder, Nisbo.
Yep. He was part of a three-man tackle.
Probably gets a Clive complaining about Umanga's shoulders being too strong and hurting Johnny's and after the game.
He tries to crawl away from that moment and not in great shape at all. So maybe expect the All Blacks to run at him again.
Four from five, it's pretty impressive. Every kick's so vital in a test match. Of course, Wilkinson nailed one from a little bit further away, but similar angle.
Good start. Good start to the second half for Daniel Carter and the All Blacks. They extend the lead to 11 points. So we'll keep a close eye on Johnny Wilkinson. Such a key player. Now let's see if we get this midfield kickoff. Aimed, it would seem, pretty much at Richie McCaw. This time they've gone down as far as Byron Kelleher. Off to Sivi Vatu. And the winger takes it to the 22. And that's a mile offside. Kelleher takes it, and away goes the little halfback. Showing good strength. Now Soialo feeds it off to Carter. Carter to Umanga. Almost got through, got the pass away beautifully.
Amazing offloading the tackle.
There it is for Sivi Vatu. He did really well to get in there quickly. Williams hoping to free the arms but couldn't do so.
Oh, good drive, New Zealand. Lions players wrapped him up, but I thought that was great.
Carter gets it quickly, at least Kelleher does. Now chance, Soialo passes away beautifully for Dan Carter. Carter kicks. chase, and Carter scores! What a brilliant try for Dan Carter.
Time out.
He wants to have a look at it. Not absolutely sure.
Well, I can tell by the look in Daniel Carter's face, there is no problem there. Magnificent try. He was by himself totally, no one in support. He was cleared with a beautiful pass, and he just chipped it ahead. And look at that. Well, a class act, Daniel Carter. Put in space by the rest of his team.
Thank you. Time on.
Murray, he's better than a class act. He's an absolute genius for his age. The way he sums up situations. Umanga's pass here was unbelievable. Carter was on his shoulder. He summed up like he was tackled. Remember, he's on the deck here.
And he got up and joined again. But look at this from Soyalo. He drew the last man. In fact, he drew two men, put Carter away. Great play, Soyalo. And then Carter just did everything right.
Ironic, wasn't it? The only other player near him was the other number 10, and he's outshone him tonight.
What a talent, Daniel Carter.
Well, if he kicks this, you've got to bow to him.
Oh, beautiful kick.
How can a man have such poise, such mental toughness to score a spectacular try and then calmly slot a goal from the most difficult position?
I don't think John O'Gibbs can answer you. He's just looking in amazement as well. The way he beats Lucy with the kick, it stays in play. You've got to have a bit of luck though, that you make your own luck. And Wilkinson can only just look in dismay.
So the kickoff again. Here they are having another crack at Richie McCaw, but he's equal to the occasion. He gives it off to Collins. Collins looking to free up the ball. But he's gone 10 metres anyway. Now it's away for Williams. What's that all about?
I'm not sure.
Lucy. Lucy, as the Lions get possession for the first time in the half, and it's almost 5 minutes gone.
Let it go, off your foot, let it go.
Get on that bus! Don't think Ali Williams expected to find himself as in the first high-rate position.
Both had hold of it, collapse more.
Now the 21 points that Daniel Carter has scored tonight are the most by any New Zealander ever against the Lions.
Over the mark, Hawkins.
I guess in the test match we'll all remember, well, those of us of sufficient age will remember Don Clark kicking six penalties and getting 18 points. But Dan Carter's 21 tonight, the most by any New Zealander ever against the Lions. So Yalo off the back.
Talk about break the advantage line, classic.
Away for Carter to do the kick. Sivivacha will be flying up after this. Lucy coming across, but they are offside.
What do you want? What do you want?
Where is it?
Over there. Be quiet.
Steve Thompson is a very excitable fellow. I don't think he's the captain, though.
Where am I?
Well, the Lions really need to grab some ball, hold on to it for a long time, really. Get a good feel. Gavin Henson, I've hardly seen him in the game. He needs the ball. The possession now, 67% New Zealand.
Good kick by Wilkinson. Let's have a look here. Sivivatu, he's behind the line.
I don't know who he is. He's onside.
He's just too fast.
Who's halfback? Yes, we've got it.
Thompson throws. They get their line-out ball.
Yeah, good line-out, the back of the line-out with numbers driving. Very hard to stop that.
Leave it.
Looks like they have stopped it, though.
Collapsing.
And collapsing them all.
Collapsing.
Now
leave,
let's see whether
the
Lions are going to move up in lots of three, or whether they'll try for another line-out.
Richard McCaw just got his headgear rucked off.
Well, they've used Easterby well, Murray, at the back of the line-out, haven't they? Lovely take off the top there. And the throwing Well, I guess even this fellow will be admiring the fact that they've been a lot more accurate this week.
Well, they've got a clear advantage in height at the back of the line out, Smithy. They've got their three loose forwards are taller than out than the New Zealand three equivalent, particularly Ryan Jones, of course. It's one area of perceived weakness. New Zealand is no real height towards the rear. So you'll see that, the lift at the back, and then the drive. Pretty impressive, really. Now, this is where it stopped. I think that was Mayalamu who just... No, that's Mayalamu there. I don't know whether they did collapse it, did they?
Well, the Lions have kicked it out, so another line out coming up.
On the line. On the line. Stay out. Stay out. Stay out. Stay out. Don't lift seven.
I'll do it again to the back.
Beyond 15.
Looks pretty well controlled, but it's gone to ground. Now Peel. Off for Wilkinson. Henson looking to get up wide. A pile driver from Rico Gear. And the All Blacks have turned them. Here's Kelleher. Got it off to Williams. And Ian Turn threw it away. Back with Jenkins. And so the Lions have it. Now Wilkinson again. Out into centre field. The two number fours come together. Chris Jack and Donica O'Callaghan. There's Shane Williams. Oh, take that. Now Mialamu.
New Zealand ball.
Leave it six.
Boy, there's some big hits in this game tonight.
Slow it up. Get your hand off and don't slow it up.
Well, the Lions finally got a bit of ball. It was from a pretty reasonable take in the line out, the second towards the rear, and then they moved it. They had to go wide. But the All Black line was up inside their marker, and a pile-driving tackle by Rico Gear stopped it on its tracks.
Well, both times was on Shane Williams. Five try Shane from Palmerston North is a long way from there at the moment.
Beautiful
Bang.
Timing.
And then to pick it up and cop it again from Ali Williams.
Great tackle.
Williams gets the line out ball too, but he's put Callahan under a bit of pressure. Oh, he did well to extract himself. Now Collins. He's had a big game too,
onside.
Jerry Collins, carrying the ball strongly. Carter now. That's a sweetly timed kick. And Williams does well to get out of this one. But Gear gets him. Now it's with Thomas. At least Wilkinson, is it?
Leave it four!
Have a third shot at it, Lucy.
Ooh, big pass.
Out into midfield. Now Moody. Chased by Muliaina.
Rock! Hands up!
Peel. Williams looking to get in close.
Oh, they've got numbers outside.
Yes, Thompson. Oh, he got away from the Williams tackle. Might have just carried it a wee bit too far, though. Now Thomas. Oh, that looks a bit dodgy. Getting very close to the head there.
Oh, good drive. Oh, what have we had?
Pushing and shoving tonight. Let's
take
see whether Stuart Dickinson saw anything.
Yep, three red and one black. Just pushing a shove and into it from there. Then everybody coming in to have a push and a shove. I'd have a quiet word to them to calm down. I'd also take the opportunity to have a word to two red as well. I spoke about before that he had another little push down here as well. So he's inflaming things. I just play whatever your original
play
was, but have a word to three red, two red and one black.
three red.
Well, Julian White needs to be spoken to.
Sorry. Three red. Video replay. Guys, just go with the ball, all right? It's the last time. Discipline is going, all right? If you stay with the ball, it'll be okay, all right? The original here was just a scrum. Too many guys off their feet. That's what we're going with, the red scrum.
Red scrum?
Yep, right here.
Well, that was a deliberate stomp on the arm. There's no question about that.
Just be quiet, all right? Settle down.
10 minutes gone, second half.
Have a look at the scrum here. Julian White on this side with Woodcock.
No call. Wait for the call.
There's White landing. You can see blood above Woodcock's eye. That's the first punch of White's. And Woodcock won that one.
Pulling. Hang around. Get back. Pulling around.
Well, he's got the All Blacks for screwing the scrum.
Just settle down.
So the Lions maintaining pressure on New Zealand's line. Another line out. They'll no doubt throw it towards the rear again where they've driven successfully.
Don't lift.
Thompson. Unchallenged. Gets it back. Big defence on O'Callaghan.
Richie McCaw, great tackle.
Here goes Moody again. Jenkins was going to pick it up, he left it. So Peel off to Wilkinson. Wilkinson wide for Thomas. Back on the inside to Williams. The All Blacks out-muscling Shane Williams, as they did at the Millennium last year. He's a very good little player, but there's not much of him.
Well, it was also weight of numbers, I thought. Great support around the ball there.
Tana Umanga, ball and all tackle, superb.
That one right there, bang. And then weight of numbers, look at that. Three, four players over the top and deservedly being rewarded with the scrum. Chance to relieve pressure.
Three, on the angle. On the angle, number three.
Getting Julian White for boring in on the hooker.
Well, it was almost tit for tat, really. That's two penalties in a row for... one against New Zealand's front row, then one against the Lions.
You just feel the Lions must get some profit from this period of play where they're starting to come back into the match. The All Blacks were to score next and have that bench available to them. You wonder if there is a comeback possibility for the Lions. They've thrown everything at this, literally everything. But they're still 18 points behind and they know it.
Still 28 minutes to go, Smithy, plenty of time.
Boy, Smithy, it's warfare out there, isn't it?
That is the most unbelievable test match, Nisbo. I spoke to a bloke at halftime, said, shouldn't this be all over? Haven't we seen enough in the first 40 minutes? Incredible.
Well, that's what test matches are about, when both teams are 100% committed, and they are, individually in this group.
Tipped on the All Black side for Callaghan. Carter off to Umanga, looking for Sivi Vatu. Here's Leon McDonald making good ground. 10-metre line in Lions territory. Carter. Such an elusive runner as Callaghan has a go.
Well, he did too. He picked the wrong moment though.
Here's Chris Jack. Time to straighten it up, he says.
Onside, no. Number three.
No, it's still All Black side.
Away for Amuliaina, Sivi Vatu. Such an elusive runner. Again, he's well held though. Gear to Collins.
It's a rock.
Carter. Gear. Oh, good strong challenge. Got through the tackle of Wilkinson. Now Chris Jack, Sivi Vatu.
lost it.
Lost it in the tackle. Yep. Yeah, good defence.
Eight phases, though.
That's four.
But they continue to ask the questions of the Lions' defence. The Lions' defence is holding, but you can feel it shaking under the pressure. Well, you can see the two tacks huddling together, or huddling individually. You huddle individually? I don't know.
Interesting one.
Territory very close, isn't it? 52-48, but New Zealand with a decided advantage of possession, 64%. The lineouts have been a very close affair. One against the throw, both teams just quite different from the first test.
Once again, the scrum is screwed away.
That was because of an experience at the back of the scrum. The Lions, number 8, Ryan Jones. Young man, but wasn't assisting the scrum and never cleared the ball.
Well, the Lions came here with this reputation for being marvellous scrummages. They haven't been able to better this All Black pack in the scrums.
It's been a couple of times. Blood bend.
They also came with a reputation of being marvellous in the lineouts as well.
Well, Julian White's going to have to go off by the look of it, so maybe we can say Tony Woodcock might have landed one as well. He's a slow bleeder. But Graham Rowntree on in jersey 17.
You want to go to the loose head side, round three.
We're right here.
So that means Jenkins over on this side to the tight end.
Don't offset. Get to crouch. Crouch and hold. You go.
Oh, scrum pressure big time.
At least two. At least trio.
Well, Ryan Jones did well then.
Stand up. Just let it go. Stand up. Stand up. Roll away. Yeah, you could get away. Get away.
I don't know how you're supposed to get away.
Well, it's a pretty helpless feeling when you're down there at the bottom and there's bodies all over you and people jumping on you. You can't do anything, let alone get away. You'd be wanting to get away if you could, but you can't. So they wrapped him up. Collins, it was, holding him. Twisted him, drove him backwards. Now have a look at that. There's a message to Jerry. Now Rodney Suralo drives over to try and stop it.
Well, Rucking's back in the game, that's official.
Yep, no doubt about that.
Here's Thompson throwing.
Ooh, better contest at the back that time.
That one bounced straight back into the line out. Peel, Wilkinson. Bit of a change of tactic here.
Yes.
Leon McDonald's got a bit of time and he did well to get away. Off that goes to Woodcock.
Oh, well driven Woodcock. Black over the ball.
Now Umaga, they're going to tidy it up here and kick it away downfield. Oh, beautiful kick.
Oh, simply superb.
He really is a star player, Daniel Carter.
He's with his left foot. Well, how heartbreaking is that for those forwards? That's a lock, that's a prop, trudging back 40, 50 metres. And that's the team feeling, well, that went exactly where I wanted it to go. Now, what's next?
Well, the interesting thing there was that Wilkinson hadn't kicked a lot in that position tonight. And when he did, it didn't work. So Thompson again lobs it in. All Blacks contesting, goes to Chris Jack. All Blacks win one of the few against the head tonight. McCaw frees it into centre field. Umunga's got it. Umunga kicks it. But it's been controlled by Lucy. And here's Carter having to skirt back after it. And he got away from one. And he got away from more than one. That is incredible. Ryan Jones. Away goes the big Welshman.
He's all over the place.
go, holding on.
Although I think Josh Lucy, when he was trying to tackle Daniel Carter.
It's Wilkinson.
Was it Johnny Wilkinson?
They look a bit alike, those two.
And this doesn't look good at all.
So Carter seized the moment. He looked up and he saw it was Wilkinson. Oh, no, it's Lucy, you're right.
Well, that's Lucy there. That's Wilkinson there. Yeah.
Same right shoulder, I think. Hit on the point of it. And the All Blacks did extremely well. They got numbers there. It was interesting when Carter got through and made the kick. It was impeded trying to make the tackle on Jones by Simon Easterby. So maybe a little bit of justice there.
I think Andrew Cole's done a good job under immense pressure. I wonder if he's ever been under this pressure before.
Stephen Jones, who started in Christchurch. Wilkinson doesn't want to go. He's got plenty of courage, Johnny Wilkinson, but it looks like he's going to have to go. So that is a sad sight. The man has played very little rugby since the World Cup in 2003. It's been an injury-plagued time for him. He gets a hand, too, from Prince William. So Wilkinson to the bench, and it'll be Stephen Jones eventually as Carter attempts the penalty.
Yes, a twist of fate, isn't it? When Wilkinson, the star number 10 of the World Cup, leaves the field with his head low, and this man here continues to slot the goals, make the breaks, do everything right.
You know, he has made a number of tackles like that tonight. Where he's really led with the right shoulder.
Okay, thank you. We're right now.
So they made a change. Rowntree's going to stay on for the Lions. Julian White is back on the park with his head strapped. And, of course, Jones at first 5-8.
So Jones kicks off. McCaw wants it. And McCaw gets it. He's accepted most of the kickoffs tonight. And he said... don't worry about it, I'll take it up. Here's Carter again, slips it to Collins. 5 metres on the All Black side of halfway. Callagher drags it out. Nowhere to go. Got to go around this way this time.
Oh, Jones, he did well, though. He was in deep trouble there, couldn't clear the ball, knew his backs were set up, so he took it on himself.
McCaw. Carter, wide it goes to Umanga, even wider to Muliaina. 10-metre line.
Lions ball, I think, is it?
Well, it's all over the place. And it is. It's got to be a Lions penalty.
It's coming back that side, hands over.
19 minutes to go.
It was turned the wrong way.
21-point lead.
Well, it's fast and furious, this game. It's just continuing to move forward. Everyone appears to be under pressure, but there's been some fantastic performances. Under pressure, the only true way to assess or evaluate a player and a team is to put them under pressure and see if they can handle it. This man can, that's for sure.
Here's the tackle that may well have ended the tour for Johnny Wilkinson.
Well, I certainly hope it hasn't. He's a wonderful player, Wilkinson.
All Blacks again not contesting. Peel cleared it away for Jones. Now Williams, a lot of Welshmen out there now as Gareth Thomas, the captain, has it.
And he's got to be penalised for that.
Let it go, Blake, let it go.
Well, I reckon...
No. He was on his feet and then they both... quiet.
No, I don't know about that.
Yeah, both on.
I would have thought Gareth Thomas should have been penalised. He wouldn't let go of the ball and Richie McCaw was on his feet. Have a look at this. He's on the deck. Richie McCaw's on his feet. He's got to let the go. He's still holding on to it with his arms up in the air.
It's straight. No,
it's Umanga, isn't it?
Yeah, not McCaw, Umanga, but even so. Thomas, the perpetrator, got away with it.
Don't offset. Get down. Crouch and hold. Engage.
Free kick quickly taken by Peel. No, not from the mark.
Well, you've got to take it from behind.
All the momentum is lost. And that really does frustrate players. Ryan Jones. Right on the 22. Now Peel. All Blacks flying up at him. Collins and Sotoyalo put him away.
And then got jumped on.
Now field for Jones. Moody. Oh, thumping defence again.
They've
playing an advantage
it.
Here. Here's Jason Robinson. Oh, wonderful defence here tonight. Jones goes again, looking to get it wide. Steve Thompson back inside to Julian White.
Players getting bowled everywhere.
Six, leave it.
Jonathan Kaplan has his flag up on the far side, so we'll have to see what the story is there. Now here's Peel. Closed down there by Callaghan.
Seven phases lines. We haven't seen too many of these.
Stuart Dickinson, I think it is, across on the far side. So here they come again, the Lions. Thomas. Thomas got through the first one. Now pops back. No room on the blind side. Big defence from the All Blacks. Robinson clears it. Now Jones off to Shane Williams. Sends the short pass to O'Connell. Out with Julian White, and that's a truck and trailer. Now let's see what Stuart Dickinson saw about 90 seconds ago.
Great, six black. Yep. Six black. Last movement here. One of the red players didn't get his number and pass the ball. Six black, late tackle.
I didn't see it. You got a recommendation?
I'd penalise him, have a word to him.
Okay. That's all? Yeah, six
absolutely.
Black.
Just here on about just the five. Here. Just over five. Here. Six black.
Yep. Tackle was late and lazy, all right? Watch your timing.
Well.
10 metres. 10.
A letter of the law, I suppose it was a wee bit late.
Where?
But how often do you see that in the game of rugby?
I didn't think it was late.
No, I agree.
And he pulled out of the tackle at that point.
Wayne, that's just pedantic.
Radio changes here, so a bit of bulk. So Jerry Collins, that is his last act of the game. Sione Luaki in jersey 19 and Justin Marshall for Callaghan, whose night didn't start that well, Byron Callaghan, but boy, has he gone from strength to strength. A terrific performance from Callaghan. Strong round the rucks and fringes.
Yes, two big performers leaving. Jerry Collins. And he gives the big salute too.
Oh, Jerry Collins has just given the raised fist. Pumped his fist to the crowd. Stirring stuff.
Well, he's a local boy, of course. They love him here. And he deserves the mantle.
So, back to the game. Thompson fires it in. Lions still having a shot at the All Black line.
Better go one roll off it. The ball's there. The
somewhere
ball's
there.
There.
Now it's coming. Away for East to be. And let's have a look. He wants to have a look
Mark,
at it. They reckon he's got it though. The Lions look pretty happy about this. Simon East to be.
You just check the grounding and touch and go for us.
Touch and go.
The whole lot, mate. I think he's hopeful, Nisbo. He might have just said there, I'm not sure.
Yeah, looks all right.
Oh. Yeah, I think that's a try. Well.
It's Marshall's arm, the one with the wristband on. That's the one that hits the line there. That's a try, isn't it?
Yeah, I reckon.
Absolutely. Well, what a time for Justin Marshall to arrive. Hardly even warmed up. Had it, trying to pull off a desperate tackle.
So the try scored by Simon Easterby, the man who replaced Lawrence Dallaglio on this tour. So, like Ryan Jones, he wasn't required in the original party of several hundred. And the conversion attempt misses. So 34-18. The All Blacks very thin on the blind side.
Very thin, yes. He spotted it too. It was well done by the Lions.
Justin Marshall tonight playing in his 80th test. So he takes over from Ian Jones now as the second most capped All Black behind Sean Fitzpatrick. Lions tipping it back.
It's a ruck now, move away.
16-point lead with 14 minutes remaining.
Ball's out. Holding red, holding five. Right now.
This kick is nicely controlled by Gear. Away for McDonald.
Let it go, seven, let it go, let it go. Make sure you get up first. Yeah, get up first.
Well, it's been a very much better performance by the Lions tonight, Murray.
Oh, it's been a totally committed forward effort for sure, and bats as well.
Stay square.
But really, they have been edged out, haven't they, by the All Blacks?
Well, so far, we're way to go, yeah.
Hey, will you be quiet? Will you be quiet?
It's interesting replacements, isn't it, when players are committed
keep
to the job
steady,
and are
Red.
In the slot and they're working hard and all of a sudden they're off the field and a new man comes on.
Aaron Whitcomb looks like he's getting ready. Marshall away for Carter. Carter gets past a few more tonight. Marshall again for Tony Woodcock.
Let it go, Rock!
Looking blindside. Lauaki. Good powerful surge by Lauaki. He's a replacement for Collins. Woodcock again. Goes with McCaw. Here's Carter. Down he goes in a heap. Not sure whether it's bait. Lucy's kick. Nicely taken by Leon McDonald. More looks looking to counter. Savivatu. Kick made by Gear. All Black chasers coming fast. Beautifully done by Jason Robinson. There's going to be a penalty here, I think. Yes, playing an advantage. Here's a chance. They must score here, the All Blacks. Carter.
I'm sure he wasn't looking to do it all himself, but he did. He had to straighten it up. He had the last defender, Gareth Thomas, I think it was, drifting. So he straightened him up like that and then kept going. He still had two men outside him.
Has there been a more commanding performance by a number 10 for a long, long time in rugby? This guy has not done a thing wrong, Daniel Carter. He's been inspirational. He's beaten so many tackles tonight. They laid off him and he said, not tonight, fellas. Give me some space. He's broken six tackles himself. Not a big man, but a great stepper and a great reader of the game.
Well, he's broken a heap of tackles, Smithy. He's broken a heap of records too. He scored 29 points tonight. He scored all of the All Blacks' points in the second half.
Horgan for Henson for the Lions while he lines us up, and also we've got Whitcomb on for Mealamu.
Well, sadly from the Lions' point of view, Gavin Henson was a non-event tonight. Conversion.
Mealamu did brilliantly, didn't he? Under pressure.
Had a big game.
Yeah.
Well, three men in support. I missed McDonald. He was right behind Carter.
First time the Lions have ever conceded 40 points in a test match to anybody. And the All Blacks may not have finished yet.
Still a lot of points. A lot of 9 minutes to go.
9 minutes to go as it goes wide to Lauaki. What great pace. Look at this. Still going. Now they free it away, the All Blacks. Tipped on for Muliaina. Umaga. Carter's there again. and the ball has gone forward. This is thrilling stuff from the All Blacks. And have a look at Sione Lauaki.
Well, he was given space on the outside, and he had a go at a winger. Well, he didn't have the gas. So he ended up setting it up, and this is the finish of it. Beautiful interpassing here. Umanga Muliaina Carter all having a little bit of a dab. Well, it is a scintillating, spectacular display by New Zealand. Offloading the tackle, I would suggest, is one of the strongest areas of this game, similar to the game against France last year.
Free kick taken again, not behind. From the mark.
Behind. Behind. Square and steady. Stephen.
Daniel Carter, 31 points.
Doesn't get any better for the Lions in terms of bulk, because Ma'amonu is about to make his way under the park for Sivivatu. It's just been another superb performance from him. But Nonu and 21, a rousing reception. And let's not forget the test of character it's been this week for the All Black captain, Umanga, who has had a sterling game under pressure.
Yes, almost faultless game too, Smithy, as you say. His defence, his pressure, his little dab to support.
Darren Whitcomb into the action with about 8 minutes to go. Oh, beautifully done by Arnie Williams. Now Lauaki. Soiolo, he held on to it only just. So Marshall gets the call from the right. Whitcomb wants it. He's a big, powerful ball runner too, Darren Whitcomb. Here's Justin Marshall having a bit of a probe.
Leave it seven.
Trying to free it off. It goes to Carter. He tips it up nicely to Woodcock. Now it's with Nonu, well taken Rock. By Dwayne Peel. Somerville knocked it back.
Let it go now! Let it go!
Turnover.
Lions have done pretty well to walk over the top of this.
Hands, Ruck, let the ball go, let the ball go.
Peel. Surely not 10 metres, the All Blacks.
Let it go, eight!
Now, Stephen Jones gets it wide to Ryan Jones. All lost and knocked down. Kept in play by Shane Williams, but no, the flag went up.
I think you've got to throw it in 5 metres. If he wasn't touched, he threw it about a metre. But even so, good attitude, Lions' desperation to keep the ball alive. Let's have a little look. So does he step out? Yes, he steps out. So then he tosses it in the air. And not quite five, I would suspect.
Another change in the All Blacks, Woody.
Yeah, Campbell Johnson in jersey 17 for Tony Woodcock. And what a battle that's been for the night. Jono Gibbs is on as well for Chris Jack.
That's the whole bench, isn't it?
Don't close it.
Is there a player left? I'm not sure.
Yeah. Campbell Johnson just waiting his turn. Good start by Jono Gibbs. Marshall. Lauaki. Soiolo.
Leave it now.
Marshall again. Away they go. Blindside. Just wide of Carter. Snapped up though by McCaw. Got it off to Whitcomb. Whitcomb. All Blacks only 10 metres away. Looking for quick ball for Marshall. Now he gets it. Umanga.
Let it go, Red.
Still coming right, Woodcock.
Woodcock good getting spot. Smothered.
Yeah, good spot tackle by Jason Robinson. Marshall. McCaw. Soiolo. Now he got the pass off to Umanga. Here's the kick and chase.
Oh, no, where is it?
Is that Carter again?
It is.
Oh. Onside 15. Advantage.
Lions coming through offside.
Number two, stay out.
So will they go short side? No, they're going to go open side, and there's no one out here. Two Lions players. And now the short side. Oh, desperation defence.
You've got to play it.
No, New Zealand would be disappointed not getting that ball. It was a try on for sure.
you had your hands on it, they can come. There, it's a bandage.
All Blacks having a bit of fun now. They might decide. Here's Marshall taking it smartly.
Well, they got a chance. They got a chance to rub salt into the wound, haven't they? And I guess they're hell bent on that.
McCaw.
Oh, try.
McCaw's in.
Well, if any man deserved to score a try in this test match, it's that workhorse McCaw. He has just been superb. He's never flinched. And he's been hammered all over the place, jumped all over, hit in the tackle, and he's just kept on taking it to them.
Can you believe what must be being said in that Lions huddle? They have given it everything tonight. They've played out of their skins compared to last week, and they are now being hammered by 28 points with a kick to come. And Richie McCaw, strength personified, superb. Read the situation and said, I believe in myself to get there, and only Shane Williams could try and stop him.
Hasn't he been a warrior tonight, Richie McCaw? And that breaks the sequence of Daniel Carter having at that point scored all the points for the All Blacks in the second half. But now Richie McCaw chimes in, and the All Blacks have scored 5 tries in this match. And you'd have to think that what has happened throughout the previous 7 days has galvanized the All Blacks. It's been counterproductive to the Lions. And here goes Carter again.
With monotonous regularity. Well, it's not monotonous for us, I guess, the All Black supporters, but consistency is sensational. So this is where it finishes. It was McCaw just belligerent in his approach.
So another kickoff for the Lions. They've done that plenty of times tonight. McCaw takes it.
Ball's out.
Ball's been lost. And lost both ways, I suspect. No, the first one wasn't a knock-on.
Well, that's Daniel Carter coming off.
So Leon McDonald has gone into first 5-8 for the All Blacks.
Pretty interesting now, New Zealand.
Engaged too early.
It looks to me as if the All Blacks are only playing with 14 at this point with 2 minutes to go. No risk with Carter.
So Peel, short pass by Lewis Moody into the arms of O'Connell. They're going to stay on the blind side. 6 or 7 metres short of the line. With just a minute remaining in the second test, the All Blacks will wrap up the series with this win. The Lions going close. Again, they work the blind side. And a crack at the line, but I think they've held them up pretty well.
Time
and
out.
Big Shane Horgan.
Time out.
No excitement really amongst the Lions players. I don't think they imagined for one moment.
It's time out now. Just let the ball go.
That, Horgan.
The video ref will decide. Yeah. You can't do any more now. Stand up. Just check the ground. We're coming back from offside.
Tell you over this side, the crowd is rising to Daniel Carter, and even the Lions fans are too.
Sign of the ball.
Yeah. Well, we've got cameras everywhere, 21 of them. One of them's up the pole. I think we need one on the grass. We could call it grass cam.
Let's have a look at this angle. Shane Horgan it is in number 22.
Well, that's clearly up on the body, but we don't know how they twisted underneath.
We're having a look at this from every angle. And still no sign of the ball there. So let's see what Mark Lawrence upstairs has to say.
Thank you. Okay. Guys, no determined. We're coming back here for penalty for offside. No, penalty for offside. No penalty.
Glum-looking Sir Clive Woodward.
Well, where would you go if you were that man? Next.
Well, just a minute remaining.
Go Black! 19, onside.
Remember, this was an All Black team that were hit with a try early on. They had to get over it. Peel now for Jones. Horgan. Jones got it back. But that swirling defence holding up. Peel again. O'Connell. Spent a lot of time in the open tonight, Paul O'Connell. Here's big Shane Horgan, the Irish winger. Peel again. Thomas kick and chase. Looked like he might have been taken out.
Moved into the way.
So it'll be a penalty to the Lions. There goes the siren. Which means the All Blacks will win the series. The Lions looking to finish with a flourish. The All Blacks will be desperate to hold them out. They won't want to concede a try in the last minute. Jones goes again. They've got numbers, but Williams gets overwhelmed again.
Let it go! Let it go, Red!
It's going to be there for Justin Marshall. And he knocked it on, John O'Gibbs. All Blacks were looking to finish with a flourish. The game is over. Tanarumanga puts his arms in the air. The All Blacks have won the series.
Well, it's been a powerful and dominant display by Tanarumanga and his team. They were rocked at the start and they bounced back. And I think the support play was magnificent, but most of all the ability to offload and the tackle, a hallmark of their game developing for sure. This new breed, this new team, who seem to be very united and very powerful together as a group. The Lions, well, they came, they had a real crack. They exploded into this game. No one could say they weren't committed, totally to a man, brutally on some occasions. But at the end of the day, they just didn't have enough firepower to match it with this New Zealand side.
Records all over the place tonight as the All Blacks have, well, annihilated, really. 48-18. Second ever, second biggest winning margin. There was a 38-6 in 1983. And no wonder there are smiles. Prince William there with the President of the New Zealand Union, John Graham, and also the Chairman, Jock Hobbs. But the All Blacks showed also tonight that they have real depth on the bench as the players all came out. And this really is a triumph, not only for the players, but for the selection panel and the coaching.
Absolutely correct, considering the All Blacks won well last week and they changed three players and one removed by injury, four players, and there was not so much as a hiccup apart from the opening try, which we must credit the Lions for, not so much the All Blacks. But he must be a very, very happy. It's a great feeling of satisfaction when you've finished a game like this as a test match player, when you know you've been challenged in every quarter. And you come through.
Well, he has every right to feel the way that he does. Tanarumanga under siege all week. And quite frankly, it hasn't worked, has it? It has not worked.
I feel it was grossly unfair, actually, after viewing the incident. It was just a smokescreen for sure. To take away probably the inadequacies of this Lions side against very staunch opposition.
So the series is over in terms of who's won it. The series is not yet over, of course, because we go to Eden Park in Auckland next Saturday night. And boy, how do the Lions prepare for that one? Getting beaten by 30 here tonight. Daniel Carter, well, will he be fit to play in Auckland? 33 points from one player. Now the Lions are coming back onto the field to salute their fans, and they have been a loyal bunch for sure.
Well, they have. They've travelled as far as you can travel in the world, the opposite side of the world, to support their men. And haven't they done it in a magnificent fashion throughout this country? Wonderful supporters, tourists. And they too will be disappointed moving on to Auckland. It'll be a tough week for the Lions and their supporters.
So to the victors go the spoils.
And the smiles. The expressions speak volumes.
Final whistle went, and Tata Rumanga had the ball at the time. I wouldn't mind betting he'll hang on to it. An historic moment. Just utter delight on the part of the All Blacks tonight. The arms raised in triumph, and I bet under the stand Ian Smith is with a very happy Tana Umanga.
Thanks very much, Grant. Well, Tana, I've got to say, that was one hell of a test match to watch. It must have been fantastic to play in.
It was. Obviously, any test is great for you, but one in front of your home crowd with the week that we've had, it just tops it off, really.
They stung you early. My God, they stung you early.
Yeah, we talked about that actually during the week. We felt that they'd come back with a lot of passion and they'd have a lot of intensity to start off with. And obviously, we didn't talk about them scoring first on us, but that's what happened, and we adjusted. And I think we adjusted well. You know, we didn't let it get to us. We didn't panic. We just made sure that all we needed was the ball. And once we got that, we started getting our rhythm and we started playing some footy.
And you played ideal conditions, obviously, and conditions to suit the game that you played for, because you create a lot from quite a long way out.
Yeah, with the athletes that we have on our side, we can do that. And we have such, such skillful players that, I must say, Dan Carter had a great game today. And yeah. It was disappointing that as it went off, but when he was on, he was creating things for us too. So everyone in that back department did well today.
Incredibly tight-knit unit, you boys. The photo at the end was quite a rare opportunity. It's still a test match to go. Jerry Collins come off clenching his fist towards the crowd. It's been a tough week, but now a special moment at the end of it.
Very much so. This meant a lot to us, this whole series, really. And for us to really have it in the bag already, we're very happy with that. But we got one more test to go up in Auckland. And we can't get complacent. We still want to do well on that one.
How about yourself personally, mate? It's been a hell of a time for you.
Yeah, these things happen, mate. You just life goes on. So I'm still here. I'm still playing. I'm still alive.
May that brand of rugby go on, Tana. Fantastic performance. We'll see you in Auckland.
Thank you very much.
Cheers, mate. Yes, a triumphant night really for Tana Umanga. And the Lions supporters, well, they're determined to enjoy themselves here. I'm sure they will do that. But they have to take the brunt of a pretty heavy defeat here tonight. 21-13, it was still relatively close at half-time. But the All Blacks took over in the second spell. 48 points to 18. Let's have a look at the breakdown of the scoring in the match. And it's really dominated on the left-hand side by Daniel Carter. He picked up two tries, four conversions and five penalties for a total of 33 points. And the other try scorers were Umanga, Sivivatu and McCaw. Thomas got the opening try for the Lions in the first 5 minutes. Easterby got a late try. And Johnny Wilkinson was only able to land two penalties and a conversion.